Is makeup bad for you? In a modern world, where you're constantly judged by how great your appearance is via Facebook and Instagram posts, there's a burden to look your best all the time. Some even refuse to go out without makeup. Wanting to be always selfie-ready, however, comes at a price. Have you ever read the ingredients listed in your cosmetics and your skincare products? Do you ever wonder whether these ingredients are toxic or not? In fact, the cosmetics we trust to make us beautiful are actually full of many harmful chemicals. And despite the fact that these cosmetics make us look good temporarily, in the end, they're going to leave an ugly effect. Here are some toxic chemical substances that exist in your cosmetics. 1. Phthalates. Phthalates help make plastics durable and flexible. They are commonly found in fragrance lotions, body washes, and hair care products, as well as nail polish, and some are even listed as a fragrance. Companies claim their fragrance formulas are trade secrets, and thus don't have to specify on the label which ingredients are included. The European Union has banned this toxic substance from cosmetics when they discovered that it is linked to endocrine disruption, developmental and reproductive toxicity, and cancer. However, it still remains prevalent in US products. 2. Parabens. Parabens are preservatives found in everything from soap to lotion to makeup. The FDA acknowledges several studies linking parabens, which mimic estrogen, to breast cancer, skin cancer, and decreased sperm count, but it has not ruled that it is harmful. Because parabens have gained such a bad rep, some companies now use phenoxyethanol, but phenoxyethanol is not the good witch of the north. It has many of the same harmful effects. 3. Lead. We all know that lead is bad for us. We stopped putting it in our paint, right? So why is it showing up in our foundation, lipsticks, and even whitening toothpaste? Lead is a proven neurotoxin linked to miscarriages, reduced fertility, and delays in the onset of puberty for females. About 7 years ago, the Campaign for Safe Cosmetics found lead in over half of the 33 brands of lipstick they tested. A more recent study by the FDA tested popular brands and found 400 that contained up to 7.19 parts per million of lead. It is inevitable that some lipstick ends up making it past the target area and into your belly. For those who wear it regularly, this could harm your health in the long run. 4. Triclosan. Triclosan is used mainly in antiperspirants, deodorants, cleansers, and hand sanitizers as a preservative and an antibacterial agent. Triclosan can pass through skin and has been linked to hormone disruption, bacterial resistance, impaired muscle function, impaired immune function, and increased allergies. Moreover, the European Union has classified triclosan as irritating to the skin and eyes and as very toxic to aquatic organisms, noting that it may cause long-term adverse effects in the aquatic environment. 5. PEG compounds. PEGs, polyethylene glycols, are petroleum-based compounds that are widely used in cosmetics as thickeners, solvents, softeners, and moisture carriers. This makes PEGs the common ingredient in cream-based products. The main issue with PEGs is that they are often contaminated with ethylene oxide and 1,4-dioxane. Ethylene oxide is a known human carcinogen, potentially harmful to the nervous system and human development. 1,4-dioxane is a possible human carcinogen that can remain in the environment for long periods of time without degrading. PEG compounds themselves also show some evidence of genotoxicity, and if used on broken skin, can cause irritation and system toxicity. PEG compounds have been used to enhance the penetration of other ingredients into your skin, which is great if these other ingredients are healthy, but not so much if they are harmful. We're not here to scare you. We don't want you to have nightmares that your future offspring will be jeopardized, all because you wanted to sport a red lip, or that your loved one will get sick because you bought her an eyeshadow palette for her birthday. But to warn you that you have to pay attention to everything you put on your face and your body. However, If you cannot trust any products in the beauty market, or if you're tired of chasing trends and fighting to comply with social norms and beauty standards, going all natural and stopping wearing makeup is not a bad choice. Remember, your looks do not define who you are. You are beyond them, and you are beautiful the way you are.